Diagnostic sensitivity and specificity, as well as positive and negative predictive values, are important metrics that clinical lab professionals use to evaluate the performance of laboratory tests, including those for the novel coronavirus. But what do they mean? Well, the diagnostic sensitivity of a test tells us how good the test is at identifying the people who have the disease or condition. In other words, it's the true positive rate. Diagnostic specificity, on the other hand, indicates how good the test is at excluding the people without the disease or condition, or it's the true negative rate. Let me give you an example. Suppose you're using a test to detect antibodies to the coronavirus, and assume that this test is both 95% sensitive and 95% specific. If you perform that test on 100 people with antibodies, you would expect to get 95 true positive test results and 5 false negative test results. Likewise, if you perform the test on 100 people without antibodies, you would expect to get 95 true negative test results and 5 false positive results. However, diagnostic sensitivity and specificity define the performance of a test in terms of the patients being tested. In actual practice, however, the test result is all that's known. So we want to know how good the test is at predicting the presence or absence of the condition or the disease. In other words, what proportion of patients with a positive test result actually have the disease? And to answer that question, we need to know the predictive values. The nice thing about predictive values is that they transform the result of the test into the probability that a person does or does not have the disease in question. But they are critically dependent upon the prevalence of the disease in the tested population. Here's what I mean. Let's use that antibody test with 95% sensitivity and specificity to test a population of, say, 10,000 people in which the prevalence of antibodies is 5%. So that would mean 500 out of those 10,000 people actually have antibodies. And of those 500, there will be 475 true positives and 25 false negatives. Now, among the 9,500 people that truly don't have antibodies, there will be 9,025 true negatives and 475 false positives. And note that the number of false positives is the same as the number of true positives. And so the positive predictive value of the test is just 50%. You may as well flip a coin. Now, the positive predictive value improves as the prevalence increases, which should make sense. When more people with antibodies are tested, positive results are more likely to be true. So using that same test on a population with a prevalence of 20%, would give us a positive predictive value of 83%. Another way to improve the positive predictive value is to use a test with higher diagnostic specificity because there will be fewer false positives. When used in a population where antibody prevalence is again 5%, an antibody test with 95% sensitivity and 99% specificity will yield a positive predictive value of 83%. Because of the test's improved specificity. Of course, the two major types of COVID-19 tests, PCR tests and antibody tests, have different strengths and weaknesses with respect to sensitivity and specificity. A scenario like the one I just mentioned, where nearly half of the positive results turned out to be false, can occur with antibody tests, also known as serological tests, if they are used to test individuals that are unlikely to have been exposed to the virus. When performing antibody tests, false positive results can be minimized by using a test with high specificity and by reserving this type of testing for populations that have an elevated likelihood of past exposure to the virus. On the flip side, PCR tests for the virus tend to be highly sensitive and specific, but their sensitivity depends on many pre-analytical variables, such as sample type and the timing of sample collection relative to day of infection. So for an example, testing a person too soon following infection will likely yield a negative result. and tests performed after symptoms of COVID-19 have resolved can actually still be positive due to sustained shedding of inactive viral particles. There is no lab test that is 100% sensitive and specific, which is why it's important to interpret test results in conjunction with other information about the person being tested. Lab tests have real value, but only when used and interpreted correctly.